On the cover of this issue of Med, we present a completely new paradigm for ventilation, oxygenation through the intestine. I'm Gokul, a co-author on this study, led by Dr. Ryo Okabe from Dr. Taka Takebe's lab. Mechanical ventilation comes with a risk for ventilator-induced lung injury in patients with already sensitive or damaged lungs, such as those in COVID. Coupled with the need for alternatives due to ventilator shortages, we got to thinking, how can we oxygenate the blood easily and efficiently without lung injury or surgery? We were inspired by loaches and armored catfish who can breathe through their intestine in oxygen-deficient environments. We realized that a similar mechanism could be possible in mammals as well, repurposing the intestine to act as a temporary breathing organ to compensate for the damaged lungs. The diffusion barrier to oxygen is low, the intestines have a high surface area, and more structural integrity than the lung. We call this concept enteral ventilation via the anus, or the EVA technology. Initially, we attempted to administer gas into the rectum of mice. We tried this with and without prior abrasion of the intestine to cause inflammation, stimulate blood flow, and disrupt the mucous membrane. After encouraging results from gas EVA with abrasion, we turned our attention to eliminating the need for abrasion and increasing the oxygen delivery by using a liquid solvent. Perfluorocarbon liquids have long been known as oxygen delivery vehicles. We believe that the high oxygen solubility and the surfactant-like properties allow us to establish a high oxygen concentration at the intestinal interface, priming the gut for breathing and eliminating the need for abrasion. By bubbling oxygen into perfluorodecalin liquid and administering this as an oxygen enema, we showed in mice, rats, and pigs that we could rescue them from hypoxia. In pigs, the oxygenation lasted for nearly 20 minutes. At human scale, 400 to 600 milliliters could be sufficient to treat hypoxia. Given that perfluorocarbons have historically been used in many medical contexts, this proof of concept of the EVA approach represents a new way of thinking about ventilation for certain groups of patients as a potential adjunctive therapy for mechanical ventilation or ECMO. For more details and the full story, be sure to check out the paper in this issue of Med. We hope you enjoy it. This work was mainly done at Tokyo Medical and Dental University in close collaboration with Kyoto University, Nagoya University, Keio University, Yokohama City University, and Cincinnati Children's Hospital and Medical Center.